Have you guys heard the good news? The news about John Cena as a Super Slam! Coming Sunday, explosions, fireballs, dicks, only on WWE Super Slam!
Well, I just woke up everyone in a 3-mile radius. I didn't time it right. Let's see. Let me see if I hear any movement. Hang on. No. All right. Well, I definitely woke someone up, but whatever. You know what? That's the price you pay for John Cena. He needs your support. Oh my god, hang on, let me just change the ticker. I was so busy laughing at that stupid fucking prank that I didn't even get a chance to change the ticker. I completely forgot about it. Oh my god. When I found that a few days ago, whenever it was like 4 a.m. Guys. 4 a.m. Laughing out loud like a mental patient. It was insane. I don't laugh at certain things like that. Like prank calls, I'll giggle. I'll be like, oh, this is pretty good. That one had me giggling and laughing out loud and spitting all over the place. I was in tears. I was farting. I was burping. It was just a combination of every bodily function just expunging from me at the same time. And it wasn't even the guy's voice. It was the horns. It was the fucking trumpets. It's like not even... It's the way he does it is good, but the trumpets are what really made me laugh. Those fucking trumpets. Alright, anyway. Donkey Kong. Here we go.
Is your name Donkey Kong?
Alright, deep keep. We're going a high tide ride. I'm not doing 3K tonight. Maybe after this. I changed my mind very quickly. What's the title screen music? I thought this game was gonna be, like, mostly ice levels. But it's not mostly ice levels. It's mostly tropical levels. With the promise of ice at some point later on. I thought, like, the bad guys froze everything. But, whatever. Oh, man. I can't tell you how happy this game makes me. Oh, I take that back. Super fucked. I missed the K. Mm-hmm.
October.
We gotta stop. I have to stop with this. Shit. Dynamic camera time. Fuck! It's not so much about the lives, it's more about the fact that you waste your time. It's about the time that you will never get back, which is ultimately way more valuable than an arbitrary number of lives that you may or may not have. But yeah, I've noticed a trend in Nintendo games. Nintendo platformers, even though this isn't developed by Nintendo. Oh god. The trend of giving a fuckload of lives and making the game difficult. So you think, oh, I got so many lives, this game easy. This game cray. But no, not really. You're still suffering. The suffering is real. It's just you have a lot of lives, so that way you're fooled into a false sense of security. Oh, shark. Whoever is coming to this Donkey Kong land, fuck. Whoever keeps coming to these Donkey Kong islands and mining all their minerals, they really need to stop and fuck off, because at this point, the only thing that's left is bugs, dicks, and trees. So how many more times am I gonna do that before I stop jumping instinctually? I don't even know if that's the word. Oh, I missed the puzzle piece. God damn it. Get it another time, whatever. Okay, this is a little different for Donkey Kong. I don't think I've ever seen. Oh, I missed the letter. Nah, that's unacceptable. I don't want to miss that letter. I feel as if this 3D camera thing that they've been promoting before this game came out, like, didn't really show up all that much, nor was it, like, even, it was a non-issue as far as I was concerned, but this is pretty cool. Does anyone here remember my Dick Simeon story? I think I need all the DK for the secret levels. Let me me see if... Okay, Cannon Canyon I'm missing. I will come back when we have forgotten what these levels look like. I will come back and do them, and do the K level. Let's just keep moving. Let's just keep moving. I'll be around here and there. I'll tell you the Dick Simeon story while I get my ashtray and have my cigarette for the night. Again, I'm not trying to look cool or anything. I usually... What I like to do is I like to talk while I have a cigarette because I consider it a very social occasion. So I go on one smoke break at work, and that's my first cigarette of the day. And I usually go out with a few coworkers. And then my second cigarette of the day and my final cigarette of the day is usually at night while I stream because I'm able to talk to you guys. So it's a social thing for me. Now, I want to tell you the Dick Simeon story real quick. Back when I was in a band, 5 years ago or so, I decided that, I don't know what happened, but the word Dick Simeon came into mind, and, so I decided that for our next show, I was going to, like, make an announcement about the Dick Simeons and how we have to save them. Because the Dick Simeons are thinking they're running out of bananas where they live, and I made up some country that sounded legit. And I said that they're eating penises instead of bananas because they're out of bananas. I said we need to get these Dick Simeons bananas so they'll stop eating dicks. Right? I was like, thank you. And I thought everyone knew it was a joke. Like, the setup was good, and then the punchline was they eat dicks. So I get up there, I do it, people laugh, some people just stare, and they're like, what, really? My friend's dense girlfriend comes up to me after the show, are you serious about the Dick Simeons? Is that real? I was like, yes. She was like, oh god, so how do I donate? I was like, wait a minute, like, you know I was joking, right? It's not a real thing. So, I fooled a few people, apparently. I think there's a lesson in here somewhere. I don't know where it is, but... Now, it's not that she's an idiot. I would say it's just that some people will... If you put on a straight face and you say something, one in, like, 100 people will believe you, no matter what you're saying. As long as you say it with a straight face... And you're just legit. And I couldn't keep misleading her. I felt guilty. Sorry, Dr. Kojak, about Twitch's freezing. It's a good thing they implemented that 20-second lag to get rid of the freezing, huh? Oh, wow. Holy shit. That is so fucking cool. Hang on. I want to see the transition again. That was awesome. Catfish thing. We're friends, right? Hang on. Damn it. We need to stop rushing into things. There is indeed a hard mode in this game, yeah. Nine puzzle pieces in this level. Farts on a sandwich. The poot crate is real, and it'll be here soon. I know, no, this is a good soundtrack. This is good music. Like I said, David Wise composed the soundtrack. That is the guy who composed Donkey Kong Country 1, 2, and I think 3's music. So he's legit. It's a good fucking composer. Wow, Diddy uses his jetpack. So you can actually, like, get a boost underwater with Diddy. Bye, Diddy. Fuck. Mm-hmm. wonder if there's a puzzle piece for getting these bananas, or if I'm just gonna waste my time. Hoo-hoo! Also, good news for anyone who's a Tame Impala fan. Kevin's working on a new album right now, and he said that it makes Lonerism seem amateur by comparison. I don't know what that means, but I think in his own way he's trying to say it's going to be good. So maybe by the end of the year, or the beginning of next year, we'll have a new Tame Impala album. If they come around again, I'm going to see them live again. Whoops. That was one of the best shows I've been to in recent memory. Fuck. Come on. You know what? Do I like Stone Temple Pilots? Yeah, I do, actually. I really... That was one of the bands I grew up really liking. Purple, Core, and Tiny Music are some really good albums. Never really listened to them beyond that. Just a few songs here and there, some scattered stuff. Like, there's a song called Bipolar Bear. I really like that one. No Way Out's really good. Sour Girl. But for the most part, yeah, early STP. In particular, the album Purple. I don't think it gets much better than that. Great guitar riffs, great vocals, lyrics. Just great. That's cool. Just gonna go right into there. What if music bands were based on their literal names? Stone Temple Pilots. I think what would it be? It would be just like temples flying a plane. Are the temples themselves the pilots? That's what I want to know. Or is someone flying the stone temples? Like, do they have the ability to fly? What if Pink Floyd was a girl? Serious question. Fucking goddamn. That little penguin just made an R2-D2 scream. What's your secret? Say something once, why say it again? That is interesting. I'm not really doing that great here, but I got it this time. I'm not gonna make the same mistake. Woohoo! Still missing another puzzle piece. So it's somewhere. Some indeterminate location. No, I saw, you know, to the right, there's one of them. I don't know where the second one is, though. Go left. People are saying go left. When you dive? Yeah, I got that one already. Damn it! I see tentacles. Irate 8. Definition of pain and suffering. The fact that I'm not gonna get this. Try one more time. Yep. Banana missions are getting a little bit tough, a little difficult. The last world's banana missions are going to be really fun. Why do I have a feeling that me breaking that chain was whoa! Oh, there's projectiles! Right into them. That's good. Right into them. Thank you. I like how the pigs have their own little area. Because we all know pigs can't go underwater. The tentacle just flopping around like that. Oh god, ink! Whoops, too fast. Shit. Looks like I'll be doing this level again. This is making me very uncomfortable. Banana game. You get more bananas. Shit, this level. King. Yeah, why does everyone hate Donkey Kong? Why are squids and, like, walruses trying to kill him? And lizards. What did he do? What did he do to these people? Crunkies. Here we go. Not news. Lots of not new. Finally. There we go. Some new ones. Two new ones out of 30 so far. That's a new one. Four out of 30 so far. Four out of 30. Another 20. Funky keeps putting himself in the toy machine. This is just a coin sink. That's all this is. Oh, another one. I got a new one. Yeah. Five. Ten squawks, please. What? Why not? Just to have the stuff. Just to get rid of some of the coins that I have, so I can get more new ones. There's Crunky. Oh, look, his beard moves. That is glorious. Look at it. Well, now it's not. Yo, that was not my imagination, right? Like, the beard actually did move. Look at that perfectly tessellated butt. Alright, now the moment we've all been waiting for. We gotta find out if their butts are red. Oh, I see what you did, Retro. You made them sit down, so we couldn't see their butts. How much you wanna bet Nintendo was like, nope, can't have that. Go back to the drawing board, Retro. Figure out a way so we can't see their butts. very, very fat owl. Hootie. Steer, stop eating the Doritos, man. No new images today. This penguin is being shot off to the moon. Sweet dreams, moon penguin. And Godspeed. When you get there, tell me how it tasted. Either that or someone's smoking the sticky icky. That owl. That owl's smoking the sticky icky. Well, any streamers, did anyone want to stream after me? Philosopher just said, perfect name by the way, Philosopher in chat just said, why do humans have butts? I am not qualified to answer that question, but I think it has something to do with I'm not even going to. There's just so many things racing through my mind right now. I could talk about poop. I could talk about sexual attraction. I could talk about the funny qualities of a butt. I could talk about utility for sitting on. Yeah, I'm done streaming for the night, guys. I'm gonna check out some art for tonight. All you Twitch people, thanks for joining as well, as always. And I'm also going to read some late Newt news. Let's start with the Newt news. So these newts look pretty dirty. This is not a very appetizing picture. Not that I want to eat the newts. Chimpanzee that newt news. Yep. I found a place where I can collect eastern newts. Not that I would need to right now. But where there are newts, there could be other salamanders. Some that I may want to collect. Because we all know that buying wild-caught caudates commercial sources is bad, right kids? Right? Anyway, I got a request from a man who wanted me to go over the difference between a newt and a salamander. Basically, all newts are salamanders, but not all salamanders are newts. Typically though, not always, a newt is mostly aquatic, whereas a salamander is more terrestrial. Here, have a picture of some boleticosids. Always gotta throw a word in that I can't pronounce. Always. Boleticosids, a genus that extends from southern Mexico, I don't know for sure, down to somewhere in the south of South America. Very little is known about these guys, and there are a huge number of them. What do you mean very little is known about these guys? There's so many of them, you'd be remiss not to study them. Cut one of the little fellas open. Right now, maybe not. Okay. Anyway. So that's your newt news from Gabe. This has become kind of a regular segment on the stream. For how long? I don't know. I'm still interested in learning about newts. I'll make a poll. I'll tell you what. I'm going to make a poll right now. I want you guys to determine whether or not we get more Newt news. Okay, and here's how we're going to do it. Straw poll. Should we get more Newt news? Okay. So you guys can vote. Here you go. Twitch, I'll link it to you guys as well. So far, 85% of you have said that they want more Newt news. That is a very overwhelming amount. This all began, if for anyone who's new, this all began when I was jokingly saying that newts are extremely underrated. Everyone talks about lizards, frogs, chameleons, you know, there's a ton of different pets that you could have in the amphibian or reptile aspect. Is that what it is? That's a geological term? Geology's rocks. Is that the, well, whatever. Anyway, so I said that, and apparently someone was so happy that I defended and brought up newts that he started sending me emails with little snippets of information, and I just started reading them. Just because newts are really underrated, and why not? You know? 5 minutes out of your life to listen to a fucking thing about a little newt. Who gives a shit? So that's my theory. Who gives a shit? So, I got some art for you guys. Check this out. BBA Man. From Defrigerator. This one's from Alizarin. He made a little... I guess that's me, I suppose. He made some, like, sprites. Some walking animations and stuff. So it's pretty cool. From Leon Shake, something really cool. Here's Bridge Constructor art. I like how Samus is at the top. There's a truck, oil, Donkey Kong oil, DK barrel. I love the DK love that we're getting right now on the stream. You guys are definitely DK fans like I am. I even see a Yoshi's Island planet in the top right there. So I like all the little references that you threw in. Pretty cool. A few more pieces of art. From Busket. Get rid of them. What do we need them for? They're little jellyfish fellas. I mean, what do they do? What do they do? We don't need them. Hang on a second. I'm having difficulty loading this next piece. From Lamango. Banana Slamma. Why you do this, Lamango? Why you do this? I you know what? I'm gonna regret showing you guys this. But this one's from Technobarry. Okay, that's enough of that. Thanks, Technobarry! From Mega Luigi. It's Doom 2 inside of Mega Man inside of Doom 2. Doomception. And, well,
do you know what time it is?
Any chance in hell that we're ever going to...
Are you ready?
Am I ready for what? Who is this?
Are you ready for this Sunday night when WWE Champ John Cena defends his title in the WWE Super Slam? Right now you can order this awesome pay-per-view event for just $59.99. This Sunday night, John Cena defends the belt
at
WWE Super Slam.
Hey, sir.
Taking on Sheamus.
Quit calling my house.
The Undertaker.
Quit calling me.
CM Punk and even Triple H and The Big Show in a spit-swapping makeout match. WWE Superstar.
Listen, hello?
That's exactly what The Undertaker told John Cena. But will he be able to take the belt from the mightiest champion in WWE history at this weekend's WWE Superstar?
For the love of all that is... Stop calling my house
John
before I
Cena.
Get your number. I will
explosion.
Track you down and absolutely tear you
Ladder.
To pieces.
James
do you understand
Oz.
Me?
Explosions.
I know you are John
Fireballs.
Cena, crazy motherfucker.
Popcorn.